أمة الإسلام أنت الخالدة في دروب النصر دوما رائدة. أمة الإسلام أنت الخالدة في دروب النصر دوما رائدة.
الرب والشجاع فتهدي الضياء لها يا قمر، أتعشقها أم رثيت لحالي فجئت تشاركني في السهر.
For these people, death was easier than to go against the word that they gave to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "I will do sabr. I will do sabr upon the covenant which I gave to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." And the house of Uthman radiallahu anhu, it was besieged for 40 days. And for 40 days, Uthman radiallahu anhu would fast during the day and he would pray salah during the night. And upon the 40th night, Uthman radiallahu anhu, he saw in a dream, he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ya Uthman, aftir indana ghada." He said, "Oh Uthman, the fast that you have been keeping for 40 days, tomorrow you open your fast with us." And when Uthman radiallahu anhu woke up, his wife Anayla radiallahu anhu mentions that he was in an elated mood, he was in a happy mood. And the first thing he did, he went out and he spoke to the guard and he said, "Unshiduka billah." He said, "I ask you for the sake of Allah, do not shed anybody's blood on my behalf." And then he took the Quran and he began to recite the Quran. And one of the rebels, they jumped over the wall. And his rebel came and he grabbed the beard of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And Uthman radiallahu anhu calmly said, "Da' lihyati, kana abuka yukrimuha." He said, "Leave my beard, because indeed your father used to honor this beard." And the rebel, his hands clapped, because he remembered not how only his father honored, but how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and how everybody else honored Uthman radiallahu anhu. And when he heard these words, he left. And then two other Egyptians, they jumped over the wall. And they knew no virtues of Uthman. They didn't know what Uthman was. And when Uthman radiallahu anhu saw them coming, this was a man whose life is at stake. But the first thing he did, he tied his sarwal, he tied his trousers. Because he was a man of haya, he didn't want his aura to be exposed. In his final moments, upon occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting and a portion of his leg was exposed, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came in and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't move. And then Umar radiallahu anhu came and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't move. And when Uthman radiallahu anhu came, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam quickly put his clothes straight. And Aisha radiallahu anha asked, "Then my father came in, a messenger of Allah, you didn't change your position. Umar came in, you didn't change your position. But when Uthman came in, you changed your position." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Should I not have haya from the man that even the angels have haya from? Shouldn't I have haya from the man who even the angels have haya from?" And then these rebels, they came and they struck Uthman radiallahu anhu on the head with a piece of iron. And the blood began to pour from the head of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And the first place where the blood fell was on the Quran. And where on the Quran? On the verse, "Sayakfikahumullah," that Allah will suffice you against them. Allah will suffice you against them. And then one of them was about to strike him with a sword, and Uthman radiallahu anhu placed his hand high to protect himself, and he cut the hand of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And Uthman radiallahu anhu, "Wallahi innaha la awwal yadin katabat al-Quran." He said, "I swear by Allah, the hand that you have just cut off, it was the first hand to write the Quran." And then he recited the ayah, "Qala lahum nasu inna an-nasa qad jama'u lakum fakhshawhum fazadahum imana." وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. He recited the verse that people say to them, that the people have gathered against you, so fear them. But they don't fear them, but nothing happened besides the fact that the iman increases. And they say, "حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ." And they say that Allah is sufficient for us, and Allah is the best dealer with affairs. And then they placed the sword on the stomach of Uthman radiallahu anhu, and his wife, she came running. And she placed her hand between the sword and they cut off the finger of his wife. And then they pierced the stomach of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And after Uthman radiallahu anhu, an 82-year-old man had passed away. One of the rebels, he jumped onto the chest of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And he stabbed him 6 times. And he would say later, I stabbed him 3 times for the sake of Allah and 3 times for myself. And then they dragged the body of Uthman radiallahu anhu to the rubbish tip. And his wife Naila radiallahu anha mentioned that his face was covered with blood. And I went into the house to find if there was anything I could cover his face with, but they had burnt everything. And then I took off my scarf and I placed it on his head. I placed it over his face. And all of a sudden I saw a person running in. And he came in hurriedly, and I thought that this man will maybe assist us. And he removed the cloth from the man who had passed away, who was the son-in-law of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam twice over. And he removed the cloth and he slapped him upon his face. And the rebels were saying, no man can bury Uthman radiallahu anhu. And the wife of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Umme Habiba radiallahu anha, she climbed onto the stairs of the Masjid Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And she said, oh rebels, no, if you do not allow us to bury Uthman radiallahu anhu, then I, the wife of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I, the widow of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I, the beloved of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, I, the mother of the believers, will descend into the streets of Medina with my hair uncovered, and I will bury Uthman myself. She knew that no rebel would stand in front of the wife of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu mentioned that I swear by Allah, if Umme Habiba radiallahu anha had descended into the streets of Medina with her hair covered, then Allah would have rained rocks from the sky. Allah would have rained rocks from the sky. And when the rebels heard the threat of the wife of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they allowed the body of Uthman radiallahu anhu to be buried by 4 people. Hassan radiallahu anhu, Hussein, Ali radiallahu anhu, and Muhammad ibn Talha. And when they were taking the body of Uthman radiallahu anhu to have it buried, the rebels began to throw rocks. They began to throw rocks at the body of Uthman radiallahu anhu. And then they wanted to bury him in Jannatul Baqi, but the rebels insisted that he be buried outside Jannatul Baqi, although today his body is inside Jannatul Baqi. And a famous tabi'een called Amrata bin Arta radiallahu anha mentions that when me and Aisha radiallahu anha came back from Hajj, we saw the Quran upon which the blood of Uthman had fell. And they say that this Quran, you can find it today in the top copy museum. She says, I saw this Quran and I saw the blood over the ayah, say yakfikahumullah, that Allah will be sufficient for you against them. And she swears by Allah that each one of these rebels died a disastrous death. Every single one of these rebels died a terrible death. Upon occasion, Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahmatullah alayh was doing tawaf around the Kaaba, and he saw a person holding onto the Kaaba, and he was saying, oh Allah, forgive me, oh Allah, forgive me, but I swear that you will not forgive me. And Abdullah ibn Mubarak was astonished by this person's dua, and he said, who are you? And he said, I am that person who struck the head of Uthman radiallahu anhu with an iron rod. And see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has disfigured my hand. And Abdullah ibn Mubarak kicked him. And he said, go away, for you are the worst of people. Abu Musa Ashari radiallahu anhu mentions that I came back from Sham, and I saw a group of people outside the masjid around a person whose hands were disfigured and whose feet were disfigured. And when I came close to this man, he said, oh Abu Musa Ashari, go away. And I thought, how did this man know me? And he said, you may not know me, but I know you. He said, I am the man who pierced Uthman radiallahu anhu with a knife. And Uthman cursed me. And look at my hands and look at my feet. See, the ill consequences of the death of Uthman radiallahu anhu was such that Hassan radiallahu anhu mentioned that I saw my grandfather, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a dream, and he was standing by the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was standing by the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he looked worried, and this was the first time that I ever saw him in a dream looking worried. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu came behind him, and he placed his hand upon the shoulder of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then Umar radiallahu anhu came behind him, and he placed his hand upon the shoulder of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And this was the day that Uthman radiallahu anhu passed away. And shortly after this, that Uthman radiallahu anhu came, and his face was full of blood, and his head was in his hands, and he said, "O Messenger of Allah, ask these people, for what sin did they butcher me like a cow?" And Hassan radiallahu anhu says that when Uthman radiallahu anhu said this, the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala began to shake, and two streams of blood came down from the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a voice came out from the unseen. He said, "Until today, no believer has taken the life of a believer. After today, until the day of judgment, believers will take the life of other believers. Because the life of a believer is more sacred than the dunya." Understand this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La zawalu dunya ahwanu ala Allah min qatl imra'in muslimin." That the destruction of the entire dunya is lighter in the eyes of Allah than the taking the life of one single believer. That the life of one believer is more honorable in the eyes of Allah than the entire dunya. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentions, "And upon occasion I was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 'O Abu Hurairah, do you have anything to eat?' And I said, 'O Messenger of Allah, I have only one date. One date.' And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, 'Bring that date.' And that date was in a pouch. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam supplicated upon that. And he told me, 'O Abu Hurairah, whenever you want to eat, eat from this date.' And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called 10 people, and they ate to their full until they were satiated. Then he called another 10 people, and they ate until they were satiated. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called 10 and 12, and they all ate from that one date. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentions that throughout the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I ate from that pouch. That one date, because of the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, had so much barakah. And throughout all the khilafah of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, I ate from that one date, from that pouch, and it didn't finish. And through the khilafah of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, I ate from that pouch. And the day that Uthman radiallahu anhu passed away, that was the day that the dates finished from that pouch. Because the murder of Uthman radiallahu anhu, as a consequence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed many barakat from this dunya.
يا أمي ما شكل السماء وما الضياء وما القمر بجمالها
أمة الإسلام ألف خالدة في دروب النصر دوما رائدة أمة الإسلام أنت الخالدة في دروب النصر دوما رائدة.